Reporters were again trying to play politics with coronavirus this week, asking gotcha questions of the president and essentially turning these press briefings as well as the Oval Office pool sprays into a circus. And Yahoo News reporter Hunter Walker was on the receiving end of some brutal words from the president after he made a false claim and a question about coronavirus testing. Watch.
For Yahoo, gentlemen, I just want to make it clear that South Korea's testing was 11 per 100,000, and we're at 17 per 100,000.
Yeah. So, are you going to apologize, Yahoo? That's why you're Yahoo. Nobody knows who the hell you are. Go ahead. Let's
based
go,
on
Jim.
The numbers I've seen,
that's why nobody knows who you are, including me. Go ahead,
Mr. President.
Just check it again.
You ought to get your facts right before. Wait, you
but we have had like we have that. Had 14.
Okay, well your facts are wrong. Let's go.
Just to clarify,
in that clip, you can see Hunter Walker makes the false claim that the United States has not tested as many people for coronavirus per capita as South Korea. And Deborah Birx helpfully informs him that he is incorrect. To his credit, Hunter later apologized for the mistake and said that he got the facts wrong, but he was not the only reporter to ask a gotcha question of the president this week. Olivia Nuzzi, who is with New York Magazine, decided that it was appropriate to compare coronavirus death cases to the Vietnam War. Watch.
In the back.
If an American president loses more Americans over the course of 6 weeks than died in the entirety of the Vietnam War, does he deserve to be reelected?
So, yeah, we've lost a lot of people, but if you look at what original projections were, 2.2 million, we're probably heading to 60,000, 70,000. It's far too many. One person is too many for this.
Olivia Nuzzi later claimed that she wasn't trying to provoke the president or ask a gotcha question, but it certainly seems that way when you consider the potential answers to something like, do you deserve to be reelected? Obviously, the president isn't going to say no during a reelection year, but if he says, yes, I do deserve to be reelected, then it certainly sounds like he's downplaying the number of people who have died from coronavirus. So he's really in a lose-lose situation with a question like that. So instead, the president decided to not answer it directly, instead dodge it a little bit. And Olivia Nuzzi was not happy with the criticism that she received for this question on Twitter. Ari Fleischer, who is a former press secretary for George W. Bush, called her out for this, and she responded by telling him to shut the fuck up. So clearly very mature individual, definitely grappling with the question that she asked and taking criticism very well. Politico was forced to update a story after claiming that President Donald Trump owed tens of millions of dollars to the Bank of China. Well, Politico didn't reach out to the Bank of China before publishing this story, or else they would have found out that the Bank of China apparently sold this loan shortly after this deal happened in 2012. So Politico quietly updated its story saying that Trump owed the Bank of China money, but obviously no longer does. But as usually happens in the media sphere, the corrections never get as much attention as the original story. And what ended up happening is Joe Biden used this false story in a media interview to bash Donald Trump. Watch.
My son's business dealings were not anything with everybody that he's talking about, not even remotely, number one. Nothing to do with me, number two. And to talk about business dealings, look at the business dealings the president has with China. He owes apparently millions of dollars to the Bank of China. He's got patents from, I mean, this is all about whether or not we're going to be able to coexist with the biggest population in the world and make sure we're the one that set the standards that the rest of the world repairs to. That's what it's about. And it's about dealing straight up and straightforwardly with China across the board.
Biden, of course, is trying to deflect from the fact that the Trump campaign is attacking him for allegedly being too soft on China. For example, launching his campaign with the claim that China is not going to eat our lunch or that they're not a threat to the U.S. He also has this major problem of Hunter Biden having business deals in China. So he was hoping to use this Politico story as a way to push the China blame back onto President Trump and suggest that he is financially indebted to China. Of course, that turned out not to be true. And after Joe Biden's interview, Politico issued a full correction to their story as well as an editor's note explaining what went wrong. Apparently, one of their biggest mistakes was not reaching out to the Bank of China, which would have told them that they, of course, sold this loan between Trump and other investors shortly after the deal happened, and certainly well before Trump assumed the presidency. And there's also an issue with the public records that Politico was using in this case, which of course is not entirely Politico's fault. Apparently these records contained mistakes on them and had not been updated to indicate that the Bank of China had sold that loan. So again, not entirely Politico's fault, but if they would have reached out to the Bank of China, which is one of the principals in this story, then they would have known that these public records were inaccurate. They would have received this statement before going to publication, and they wouldn't have to correct the story. I would say Politico obviously didn't do their full due diligence in this story, but I respect the fact that they gave this full correction and explanation of what happened, as well as an apology saying that they regret the fact that this story was inaccurate. It's certainly more than places like CNN do. CNN still hasn't corrected that Trump Tower story about Michael Cohen, for example. But this seems to happen a lot in the media, and oftentimes it's because these reporters get a story that is designed to attack Trump or looks really negative for Trump, and they just assume that it's true because they have these deep-seated biases against the president, and they're more likely to believe negative things about him than positive things about him. And they run with these stories without doing the full investigative work that's usually required from a claim that's so aggressive like this one was. So props to Politico for doing the right thing and fixing the story, but they should have had it correct in the first place, obviously.